been about 60 days since I was here last. It's mid-August. We're back in the general area. Doesn't look like the forecast is going to let up. It's going to continue to rain for another the 7-day forecast. It's rain every day, but we got a little break right where we're standing. We posted up last night in the teepee. Got the fire going pretty good. Word is the bears are still a little bit low as well, so these mountains right here, they flatten out around the corner. Opens up into a huge basin with a river. We got about 4 or 5 miles. But our destination is about 20 miles, so now we got, I don't know, 17 miles to go. 16. But we're not gonna do it all in one day. We're gonna take our time getting to where we need to be. There's a lot of country to look over before we get there, but we'll see what happens. Maybe run into a bear before then. Well, we made it into this little river basin, big river basin, I should say, and glassed for about an hour here in the bottom. We're gonna make our way up the river bottom a little bit here and try to find a good place to set up camp. And then we're gonna glass this basin. Like I said, it's part of the way to where we wanna go, but not quite there. Down, folks. We barely got the tent set up just as the rain started to just dump. So got in here, got set up, got everything indoors. It's all dry. Kind of cool. We dried out on the way here, and all our gear's dry. So that's kind of handy because, you know, we made some progress today, but got spared a torrential downpour on top of us. But it's coming down hard now. I think we're gonna finish getting the stove set up, and then it's just camp here for a day, you know, or longer, depends. We do wanna get further up this canyon and then up and around the corner into some real remote country, but we could still probably spend a day right here. Maybe, we'll see. If we get a little break in the weather, we might push on. Otherwise, we'll just kinda sit here and hunker down and glass from the front doors here. We have a good vantage point from this position, so let's see what happens. Well, we've been sitting here glassing for a little while, and I spotted a bear on the ridge 5 miles out. You can kind of just see this black dot moving up and down in the green. There's blueberries right there, huckleberries. But he's smashing them. Looks like a black bear though, not a grizz. So keep glassing, but it's cool to see a bear. This time I didn't get a black bear tag, but if we should kill a grizz today, I might be wishing I had a black bear tag, because then I'll still have 9 days left to hunt. But I got plenty of black bears under my belt. Lots of meat in the pantry right now. It's a canned bear. Just need a grizz. That's what I need. Stay focused, Brian. Stay focused. Stay focused. Well, we got our tent all broken down, and we glassed a bit this morning. I saw some caribou up here on these this mountain top, kind of skyline near the top. It was pretty cool. But other than that, haven't seen any other critters. And our new plan is to make our way to the back there. See where the sunshine is glistening off all the green? We'll call that El Dorado. We got a 7 mile march to El Dorado. That's also where we saw that black bear. It's back over there too. It's a natural funnel. And we're hoping when we wrap around there, we'll see more bears. So we got about a 7 mile hike today?
Yeah, seven-ish.
So what's your prediction there, big Chris?
Probably gonna kill one about 3.5 miles once we start our walk.
I like that
probably
idea.
Spot one up there near that little patch of pine.
All right.
And then we'll just...
I like that prediction.
Clean it. Be back at the airstrip by tomorrow.
That's right. Seems like that's too easy, though.
Yeah.
Seems like that might not pan out. But I like your optimism.
Another 30 miles walking for
us. Right. We need to go about 30 miles or more before we can, get ourselves a grizzly. Seems like it's a little premature to get one now. We need to suffer more. We need to get wet, more wet. We need to, get blisters on our feet and burning, aching legs, all the things. Heavy for all this bushwhacking stuff. At least it's not raining at the moment. Trail right here. Love to spot a grizzly bear right in here. Or a close shot. A little creepy though. Bushwhacking where there might be a sow and cubs around any corner. I don't like that. Teepee put up, and we glassed for a couple hours, but it was a pretty decent day today. It didn't rain as much as we thought it was gonna. It's coming down now, but we got lots of wood, but it's all wet. It's hard to find anything around here that's not soaked to the bone, but we got it all inside the teepee here so we can dry it out as soon as we get this fire cooking. And try to dry out some of our gear. And word is there's a number of grizz right in here, and there's some big ones too, but so far I mean, we'll find one, but it's only our second day. Got that fire going?
Yes, she's rocking.
Even with all that wet wood?
Yeah, it's trying to get it. You can hear it popping.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like that rain just quit. Let up. There's some sun spots over here and then some clouds here, and it's really broken up, but yeah, sounds like that rain just quit, so I'm gonna put the camera away and get back outside and glass some more. Last for a couple hours. We did see that black bear. He came back out on the ridge here where he was last night. Poked around, ate for a while. It's pretty cool to watch him. He basically in the same spot. He hasn't moved at all. Just need to find a grizzly that'll do that. So yeah. Need a grizz to act like that black bear. But we're gonna hit the sack and then hopefully tomorrow we put our eyes on our first grizzly bear. Let's see.
So we had some black bears right on this front slope here, another one in the middle, and then another one way on the back. Almost, he actually got on the spine and then bailed over the other side. And then that sow with cubs was up in this next bowl over there, playing in the cubs were playing in that little bright green spring that comes up over there, a little mossy patch, and they went up deeper into the mountain, so hopefully their dad's somewhere around here rolling around. Still early, got another 10 hours of light or so. 9.5-ish, so plenty of time.
What you doing over there, Chris?
Get some of this wet stuff dried off. Trying to see how many times I can burn myself on this trip.
Isn't it crazy how like, even though we have the doors wide open, that little stove going, this little half shelter, it's still pretty cozy.
It is cozy in here. Probably take a nap.
Just burning through the wood like,
oh yeah,
wildfire.
This river wood, once you get it dry, this driftwood, after it's the edges of it are dry, it just goes up quick.
Time to spot a grizz. I got a feeling now the rain kind of stopped, they're just gonna pop up and start walking around, kind of like I just did. Gotta stretch. The old calves are a little bit sore. The old calf muscle right behind the knee, both of them, a little tight from the heavy packs. Got a seriously heavy rig coming out here because we knew we were probably going to be back here the full 10 days, and then add on top of that just the type of weather you might get. Lots of rain gear. It's a little heavier than some things. Got the full kit for the harshest weather. Rifle, and then all the camera gear. It's a heavy load, plus a little extra food as well. About 2.5 pounds of food per day. At about 10, 11 days, it's getting lighter every day though, because we keep eating it all. I'd love to see a grizz just walk down the river drainage. Just cruise on down, that would be perfect. Just tuck in right here. The wind is, you can see from the smoke, the wind's going this direction, so in theory, we could catch anything coming from this drainage, this river drainage, or up from the way we came. All of them look good. We got three black bears up on this. They disappeared a couple hours ago. They just kind of blended into the green brush and they're gone. But they all popped out all at the same time. It's uncanny. Anyway, that sow and three cubs right over there. Get the glass out and see what we can find.
Black bear just popped back out. Same spot he's been coming out, right over there by that little draw.
That's the smaller of the two.
Yeah. Smaller of the three.
That's true.
Yeah. So if he's back out, hopefully some grizz are moving around. We still haven't seen that sow and three cubs come down yet out of that draw. It could have been deep in that brush though. It was pretty thick over there.
I like it that the bear popped out as soon as the rain stopped. Get them up on their feet, cruising around. That bigger black bear is right over here somewhere, right in front of us. But they're popping out. Tucked into that brush pile right there.
He keeps looking downhill. Makes me wonder if there's something bigger chasing.
Yeah, he's got the hell out of Dodge. He's booking out of there. This makes me think something's going on.
It'd be real nice to see a grizzly pop up out of that brush.
Something has him spooked.
Must not have liked the first place he laid down up there. Not enough cover. Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Oh, he is moving.
Isn't he?
He's not even stopping to eat.
Something now has him going, dude.
Yep, now he's running. Oh, he just ate it.
Something's got him spooked.
Yep. Where is it, though?
Is he just eating now? How random.
Maybe he was in a hurry to get to his favorite berries.
I guess so.
Had to get to the spot.
Yeah.
And now he's sitting down eating.
I don't know, he's running like he's scared, but then it's like, oh, there's food. And he stops and eats.
He keeps looking downhill. So he's looking for something.
It couldn't have been us, because
no, wind's blowing
our wind is in our face.
It'd be nice to see what he was scared of.
Be nice if it was a big giant grizzly bear.
It'd be real nice.
Right there at the bottom. Something seemed to have scared him out of the bottom.
Yeah. He was booking it.
He was trucking up that drainage straight up. I thought he was going to go over the top before he stopped and cut left. Bear is just sitting up there in that bush. It's kind of right on the edge of the green where it meets the gravel. Like he's prepared to go right up the rock face if he has to. Something spooked him, made him go high. But we don't see anything right now, so maybe we're gonna set eyes on a grizzly. But it's not a bad view from right here. I mean, all these three drainages all come together in one, you know, one little section here, and we're right on the corner. Got a good wind. It's possible a grizz comes right up this drainage, or down that drainage, or this one. Just walking the river bottom. It's probably pretty likely, actually. They like to travel easy paths as well. The rain subsided a little bit right now, so we got a little bit of time. We could pop out and glass behind us a little bit in our blind spot, but all in all we can see quite a bit from inside this teepee. You can see way down there, and Chris can see way over here from his angle, so we'll probably just be here all day until dark. But if we do see a grizzly bear, it's going to be challenging to try to intercept him, because unless he's down here within shooting range, because it's just
would be sweet.
They're just cruising so fast on these big tops, and they just wrap around the corner and they're gone. So it's not gonna be easy. We're gonna need a little bit of luck. We're gonna need things to pan out for us a little bit. But anyway, tomorrow is supposed to be decent weather, and the day after that as well, and then it's gonna rain hard again for 3 or 4 days, so the next 3 days could be real good. Yeah, we'll see what happens. Put the camera away and get back to glassing. Cool though, we're able to glass right outside the shelter. Been glassing all day. Got a couple times today that the clouds and the fog kind of dissipated in the sunshine, and then just for 30 minutes a couple of times, and then the clouds came back and the fog came back and the rain came back, and it's been most of this kind of stuff all day. Doesn't seem to stop the bears from moving around though. Chris, what we saw, bears keep moving around 7:30 or 8 o'clock and at night, and then around 10, 9:30 or 10 in the morning. So we'll see. This bear is moving out a little bit early, but I don't think he's moving because he wanted to. I think he's moving because he got scared. But anyway. Kind of a long, slow day. But at least we're dry. Oh, shoot. Looks like today's not gonna be the day. All right, folks, I hope you enjoyed this week's episode. This is part four. This was part four of a now five-part series. We actually have been going through the footage. We really don't have enough to do six parts, so this is going to be a five-part series. So tune in next week because there's success, finally.
There's a bear hits the dirt.
Yeah, there's a big grizzly bear that we finally come across. Now, on this leg of the trip, you guys, you can see it's totally different than before. Yeah. We were there in June. Now we're there in August. It's so green. And black bears were everywhere, like dotting the mountainside, eating blueberries.
Yeah, see, in the springtime, I think we were a little late for them eating the blueberries. But then you were there, I think, perfect timing.
Yeah. On this hunt in August, it's thick.
Yeah.
And the weather had us socked in quite a bit more than in June.
Yeah.
Being trapped in the tent all day, we leveraged the Seek Outside Red Cliff. We'd set that thing up where we had visibility, you know, like 180 or more.
Yeah.
And we stayed inside there and were able to glass and cover ground efficiently and just wait for something to happen while we stayed tucked away and didn't get drenched. Because a lot of what happens on these type of hunts is it's all about management of moisture, staying dry. And a stove and a hot tent is also critical, I think, for this type of hunt because it just changes your mood. We were actually burning wood with the doors wide open, so we had a nice warm stove going. And in the meantime, we were sitting there glassing the whole range when it was dumping rain. Then when it stopped, we'd pop out and, you know, walk around and glass a little more and tuck back in. It was like 3 days of this. And in the next episode, we finally get a break in the weather and we get a little more movement. But this place is just awe-inspiring beauty.
Yeah,
everywhere.
It's so different than when I was there with you in spring.
Oh yeah, I mean both times were beautiful, but this was something different.
Absolutely,
we got to cross some rivers on this next episode. It's pretty sketchy. But we get back in there a little further, and we find our grizzly bear. All right, we said we'd give away a pair of trekking poles to some lucky person who left us a comment on YouTube.
Yep.
And we also are giving away a pair of sheep feet to some lucky person who is a paying supporter over on our gritty.locals.com site, the Gritty Stealthy Community. And we also are doing a Stealthy Hunter rifle cover for those who were gracious enough to share our film on their Instagram page. So, Brad, scrolling through the YouTube, you got us a winner.
Got a winner. All right, so winner is Chad Shepard. The music at the end is spot on. Love the videos, like always. It's my Sunday sit down at dinner and watch you guys is the thing to do. My kids even know what's up on Sundays.
Right on. I do like the idea of Gritty Sundays. Guys, if you're in need of some poles, go over there, check them out. They're carbon fiber upper, they're aluminum lower.
Yep.
They have the perfect weight to strength ratio, I think. They're tougher than hell.
Yeah, and we put them
I like the clip locks. There's just so much I like about the Peaks poles above what else is on the market.
Yeah.
And use the code GRITTY over at Peaks. And also check out their gaiters and headlamps too because they're legit. All right, so we're giving away a rifle cover, so a Stealthy Hunter rifle cover.
Yep.
Who'd you pick, Brad?
The Quadzilla.
All right. Congratulations on that. And then we're going to do a live stream like we always do on Monday after we release a film over at Locals. It's gritty.locals.com. If you go over there and you sign up and you become a supporter, you could be entered to win the sheep feet that we're going to give away this week. But also, we're going to do a dark energy charger, which is one of these right here, power bank. We've been using these for, I don't know, since 2015. I know that for sure.
Yeah.
I still have my originals. This is the Poseidon. This charger is pretty sweet. We're going to give one of these away to someone who's a supporter on Locals. We're going to do a giveaway this week for everybody who likes and comments and subscribes to the YouTube channel. You'll be entered to win a pair of sheep feet. It's a pretty expensive product, but it's legit. You buy it once, and it pretty much lasts a very, very long time.
Yep.
And for those who don't know, the sheep feet orthotics are awesome. and I'm going to pull them right here up in front of Brad again. I use them every day. They're custom orthotic. Sheep Eat will ship you the mold.
Yep.
You'll imprint your foot on it and ship it back to them. There's instructions on how to do that, and it works. It just flat works. Yep. It makes a huge difference. These long hikes, grueling in the mountains, even running. I have a pair that I use for running. That's a 3/4 length pair. Anyway, they are game changer for you guys. If you're having foot problems and anything, or your foot slides around in your boot, yep. that kind of thing. These things are great. If you want to be entered to win a pair of these Sheep Feet orthotics, just leave a comment, like, and subscribe to this channel. Also, share our video on Instagram, and we're going to do a pair of Peaks Elite Trekking Poles. Yep. Don't forget to use the code GRITTY at Mountain Ops. Right now, you can win an elk hunt for two. Mm-hmm. If you go over there and use the code GRITTY, every order you put in gets you entered to win. And it's a cool hunt. You can do it rifle or bow. It's in Colorado with Bear Mountain Outfitters. It's going to be a cool trip. So if you want some Mountain Ops anyway, use the code GRITTY over there. Get yourself entered to win. And check all the links below for further discounts and deals from our partners. Each time you support our partners, we get a kickback. It helps us out. Use the code GRITTY at Sheep Feet. Use it at Peaks. Use it at Stealthy Hunter. We appreciate all the support. Thank you, and we will see you next week. Stay gritty.